In simple terms, Ohio baseball hit, pitched, ran, and defended well on Tuesday night against Moorhead State at Bob Wren Stadium. And fittingly enough, in wrapping up a nine-game homestand, the Bobcats scored 9 runs in a 9-1 win over the Eagles. If you do all 4 of those things better than the opposition, you're going to win the game every time. The Bobcats outhit the guests 10-8, effectively used 3 pitchers, stole 2 bases, and didn't commit an error. Shortstop Dan Schmidt had a 3-hit night. One of those hits was a 3-run homer in a 5-run third inning.
You know, it was a midweek game. It was a lot of fun. We were real loose today. Came out, scored some runs. Pitcher made a mistake. He threw hung a curveball up and took advantage of it.
In midweek games, you generally see a lot of pitchers. The Cats used just 3, and they all were spotless. Jake Miller pitched the first. Sean Kennedy went 5 1/3, allowed just 3 hits and Moorhead's only run. He took the win. Brad Presbita went 2 2/3 to close it out.
Well, obviously we played, I thought, extremely well, one of our best games of the year. Jake Miller did a nice job going out and being efficient and knocking out that first inning. And then Sean Kennedy was very, very good with throwing strikes, challenging hitters. And then, Brad Presbita bounced back from a couple of rough outings that he's had recently and pitched extremely well. So I couldn't be more happy. We went the entire game, 9 innings without a free base. First time we've done that all year. And that's, when you do that, that's kind of what these games look like.
This is a critical time for Ohio and MAC play. The Bobcats have 4 league weekends left, have 5 wins to this point, and head to Muncie, Indiana this weekend to play Ball State. To qualify for the MAC tournament, the Cats must win more than they lose the rest of the way. Perhaps the momentum of the midweek win will help them out. All games in Muncie are on WOUBAM and OhioBobcats.com. For Chris Sabo, I'm Russ Eisenstein. This is Bobcat TV.